Hello everyone, myself am Vinod Kumar and I welcome you to the course on control systems. So the control system is very essential when we go for the automation process. When we want to automate any function and we need to concern about the system properties and the type of input we apply and the desired output what we expect. So the automation not only in engineering, the concept is widely used in engineering, but also implemented in other fields like medical or financial or management, not limited to this, and in many fields to make the system performance efficient and to get accurate result and for the automatic process we do implement the control system concepts. So basically we define the system is a connection of components. The group of components are connected together to perform a specific function. For example, considering the spinning mill industry's process, so the input raw material in spinning mill is the cotton and output material we get is thread. So several components and machines are connected in spinning mills in when we apply the input, and all the machines are responsible to produce the thread final output. So the function here is producing thread by the group of components. If we consider communication system, the components which are the elementary concepts which are there in the communication systems are a transmitter and channel and receiver. So the group of components are connected together and the task of these components to perform the function that is transmitting the message from source to destination. So these group of components connected together are called system. Also, if we consider industrial process, the systems in industries are performing function with the input variables, so maybe the temperature and pressure, flow, level. These are the physical quantities being considered in the system process in industries. And we will see in control system is actually carrying this input variable and controlling it to perform specific function. So the system may have a single input. Generally in control systems, so the mathematical notation of inputs are given as R of t and output is represented as C of t. Okay, so the input can be single or multiple. If it is single, that is R of t and C of t. If you have a single input to the system and the output is also single, generally that is single input, single output system, SISO. And when we go for multiple inputs, let's say R1 of t, R2 of t and up to R P of t, and we get the results as C1 of t, C2. So when we go for multiple inputs like this, so the system receives multiple inputs and producing multiple output. In such case, the system is said to be MIMO, that is multiple input, multiple output systems. So this is the basic definition of a system, and control system is controlling the process of the system. So the output quantity, say that is E of t, is controlled by the applied input. So the input can be reference input, so maybe the expected output, what we expect. And if the output quantity is controlled by the applied input quantity, then the system is said to be control system. And basically there are two classification of control system, and that are open loop system and closed loop system we are going to study next. And in both the case the output quantity is controlled by the applied input quantity, but there are differences. The feedback component we connect to the system that varies the type of the system. And in this course we are going to study how to design a control system, and to design a control system what are the techniques, methods, algorithms we use. And once the system is designed, we do analysis. So we find whether the response is received properly or not. So we will go for time response analysis, frequency response analysis and stability analysis. And there are different techniques and algorithms we use to analyze for these all. Whether the output is received properly or not, by the way we check whether the system performs properly or not. Here the control systems, there are basic classifications: open loop and closed loop system. So both are the systems which are performing some specific function and a group of components connected together. So this is our plant. Say the system is producing the output, and if there is any external disturbances, and due to the physical properties of the components connected in the system, there may be a deviation or variation in the output that cannot be controlled automatically. So there is no feedback. The output quantity is only can be controlled by the input variable. So the corrections are actually made manually here. And this is simple for simple application, for simple function. We go for open loop system, and there is no feedback. So in case of closed loop system, the system can correct the variation in its output automatically. So the block diagram given here is showing how the basic elemental things which are there in the closed loop control system. Here we have a reference input, the expected output. Here what do we require, what we actually expect at the output side is given as a reference input, and followed with error detector. So the reference input signal is given to error detector and followed with the controller. Then the controller output is given to the plant and the open loop system, we say, and the finally output. So this samples of output is taken by feedback element and converted back to the type of the signal, so reference input signal, and comparing the feedback signal with the reference signal in order to check whether we get the desired output or not. So the error detector is comparing the reference input and the feedback signal, and if there is any deviation, it produces error signal. And based on the error signal, the controller is performing the task producing the actuating signal. And this actuating signal is input to the plant, and the system will reprocess and producing the output, and the feedback is keep on checking the output, taking the samples continuously, and the continuous monitoring will result as finally expected output. For example, let's say our reference input is 5. So that is what we are expecting at output side. And initially when the input is applied to the controller and followed with the process, if the final output in the first stage produced, say for example, 4, and the feedback element is taking the samples here, and the error detector here comparing 5 and 4, that is 5 plus minus 4, resulting the error signal 1. So here the error signal is E of t, the mathematical representation of input is R of t, and error signal is E of t, output is E of t, and the actuating signal can be represented as M of t. So the error signal is the value 1 is applied to the controller. The controller is designed in such a way that is producing the actuating signal and trying to bring the expected result that is actually processed by the plant. For example, in the second turn, that is after producing the actuating signal, the measured, we can see the actuating signal or measured signal. So see, the value is changed into 4.5. so this feedback, the closed loop system is continuously keep on checking the value from the output side, and the error detector is comparing so until the value reaches 4.5 to the next just ask 4.67, and the controller is controlling the process of the plant and the variable. Finally when it reaches the output 5, then we get the accurate result. So the expected output is 5, but the deviation may be maybe due to because of the physical properties of the system or any external disturbances to the system, the deviation here is 0.5, and that is actually corrected by the controller, and the system function is controlled and final expected output is reached. So this is how closed loop system is working, and these are the basic elements of the closed loop control system. Let us see one practical example of a control system. Here I am considering level control. Here we have a tank, we have a water flow through the pipe connected, and water flows here. There is input, water level in, and here we have outlet output. And here, let's say for example, we maintain two levels, that is low level and high level. And when water flows through the pipe, the tank gets filled, right? The tank gets filled, and we need to maintain both the levels, like high level and low level. So initially, in the control system concept way, high level value is the reference input. Let's say the water is keep on filling the tank, and when the water level reaches high level, so the sensor detects the level of water in the tank, and these sensors are actually connected to the controller. Also, the controller outputs are connected to the relay which are there in the pipe, which are there in the water flow pipe. So when the level is reached, it's like the sensor is acting like a feedback, and the feedback signal is compared here in the controller itself by the error detector. And if there is any deviation, yes, here the deviation is the level is filled and there should not be any increment in the level of the tank. So it sends the command signal to the relay circuit connected in the upper pipe. So the valve closed here, it stops the water flow. And in second case, if the water is flowing out and the level is decreasing, when it is going to reach the low level, the input R of T in this case is low level to the controller, the sensor. So when the level is reached here, when the water level is reached here, when the water level is reached here, the sensor is acting as a feedback element that is sensing the level of the water in the tank and sending the signal, feedback signal, to the controller, and it compares sending the actuating signal to the relay circuit. This relay circuit may close here and this may open the valve in the top. So this is how the closed loop system works. Like input here are high level and low level, these are the reference input, and the feedback elements are the sensors connected in low level and high level, and the controller, maybe here we have all like error detector, and the controller is producing the error signal and sending the actuating signal to the actuator. In the control system, we do have a sensors and actuators mandatory to process, to automate the process. So the system, the whole system process is controlled here, and we get the accurate result. So let's see what are the advantages and disadvantages of both open loop and closed loop system. The open loop system is actually simple and economical. So considering open loop system, yes, it's simple and economical. There is no much complexity in the system, and number of components we use in the open loop system are less, so easier to construct a stable system. But the disadvantage here in open loop system is inaccurate, because if there is any external disturbances in the system due to the physical properties of the system, and the results produced by the plant may be deviated, and we don't get finally accurate result. So it is not reliable, and there is no automatic correction, and these output quantities changes because of the disturbances. The changes vary with respect to time because of the physical properties of the system. So, but in case of closed loop system, we have a feedback element. The feedback element compares, keep on comparing the output and monitoring it, and trying to bring us the desired output. So we get accurate results, and the time response can be adjusted to appropriate by appropriate design. And it is less immune to noise, and there is, even if there is any external disturbances, this is able to correct it automatically. But the disadvantage here is complex and costlier. Yes, obviously, number of, because of the closed loop system, the automation process, number of components used in the whole process is increased. The feedback connected in the closed loop system may lead to the oscillatory response. In a real-time system, in the dynamic case, we have oscillatory in output response. And we are going to study different methods to overcome this oscillatory response in upcoming videos throughout the course. And also the feedback is reducing the gain of the system. Yes, so there is a stability problem. And to overcome these advantages, what are the methodologies, the technique we use, that we are going to cover in the course. So in the overall, throughout the course, we are going to study the design of the control system and analysis whether the designed system is working properly or not. We go for time domain analysis, frequency domain analysis. Yes, we go for different orders of system. The first order, second order systems, practically we have multi-order like dynamic system, and in case we have a stability issue, we go for stability analysis also. Yeah, I suggest you to go through these textbook, the Control System Engineering by Nagraj J and Gopal M, and Automatic Control System by Benjamin CQ. And these are the textbooks which will help us to understand the conceptually how the control system is designed and how it is performing and what are the analysis we have to do. And for examination point of view, we will solve more problems in several videos. So keep on touching with the course, and if you have any doubts, please post it in the comment box and we will reply for the doubts as soon as possible. Yes, thank you.